今天是7月4号，美国国庆日，也是美国的国定假日。我和六位朋友相约来到蒙大拿州的冰河国家公园。我们是前一天就出发，从犹他州往北开将近10小时的车程，已经快到加拿大的边界。那由于温室效应的影响呢，公园内的冰川正在逐渐退缩。那退缩后的冰川形成许多美丽的山川、湖泊跟瀑布。那风景从大到小都充满特色，变化万千。那我们现在就准备出发。我们第一个景点来到麦当劳湖旁边的 App Guard Village， 要来划独木舟。我们总共7个人，租了3艘2人独木舟跟1艘单人的独木舟。
All of your boats have wheels on them.You're gonna take those wheel, or you take those boats. You're gonna pull them down the lake. You're gonna stay off of the sidewalk, but next to it, so that cars can pass you and people can have the sidewalk.
Okay.
When you guys get down there, you can put in the water anywhere along this lake shore. I would suggest over here by this public dock. When you get out on the water, you can go left or you can go right, but do not go down the creek. If you go to Fish Creek and back, that's a real good 2-hour paddle.If you go up that way, there is a restroom at Fish Creek if you were to need it. You'll pass a buoyed off area. That's where there's an active eagle's nest. We ask that you stay out of the buoys and just observe the eagles while paddling. We don't want you hanging out there for too long. Do not go in the middle of the lake. It is extremely windy out there. It can push you all the way to the other end of the lake, which is 10 miles away. The lake is 1 mile wide, so this doesn't look very wide, but it is. And the lake is also 472 feet deep. So if you guys were to drop anything while you're out there, it's going to be down there for a while. Any questions on that?
我们现在要准备下水了，后面就是我的队友李贤姐姐。我们已经在湖上了，然后我是坐后座，我就是耍废队友，我只负责录影就好了。我们现在在麦当劳湖上在划 kayak， 那这个湖面今天非常平静。那我们租的船费呢是双人大概36块美金，单人的28块美金，然后可以划2小时，还算蛮划算的。建议大家来的时候一定要来体验看看。 们划完了，总共划了2小时，准备上岸去还船。我们现在来到第二个景点，叫做 Rocky Point Trail， 这个是麦当劳湖的一个环湖步道。后面这个湖呢，跟我们刚刚划船的湖是一模一样的。那我们现在来湖边吃午餐。我们再去下一个景点的路上，一样经过的是麦当劳湖。我们要去雪崩湖的路上，在旁边看到了麦当劳瀑布。我们来到的下一个景点是要去看雪崩湖，那这个景点非常有名，人非常多，那而且冰河国家公园里面的天气非常不稳定，已经开始下雨了，那我们3天的行程可能都会遇到类似的天气。在去雪崩湖的路上，旁边有一条溪流，然后有看到一棵已经被连根拔起的树干。雪崩湖是个高山湖泊，那刚刚旁边就是雪崩湖流下来的溪流。 我们在下雨的泥泞中爬了 3.2 公里，来到了雪崩湖。山上那一条一条的都是瀑布，只可惜天气有点太差了。
要值得吗？
我们来到今天最后一个景点，叫做 Weeping Wall， 它是在路边的一个瀑布。我们刚刚沿路开过来，这条路叫做 Going to the Sun Road， 是一条开在峡谷上的路。那沿路上也可以看到非常多的峡谷地形，也是滨河国家公园横跨东西向的主要干道。那我们就明天继续。